Hello, I'm Dustin Kirkland here at KubeCon, and I'm joined by Lakshmi Sharma, Director of Product Management at Google. Her team works on some of the hardest network problems at Google. Lakshmi, can you tell us a little bit about what it takes to think about networking at tremendous scale inside of GCP and with Kubernetes?
Sure. So a lot of work that we do in networking, to be honest, this has been done like over 10, 12 years. Like, you know, we all know that Kubernetes really started from the infrastructure management right inside Google's data center, like Borg. And so most of the networking pieces that we have, they really run all Google's applications at scale. Whether we talk about global load balancer, internal load balancers, and then doing that at the geographical scales, at which we support already 4 billion users, like, you know, 4 billion containers every week. So that's the kind of problem we have, to be honest, solved at the connectivity level, DDoS level, and all of it. But now taking that problem and trying to solve problems for our enterprise customers, right? So that they can get the kind of scale for business, just like we at Google have solved, right? So that's the problem we are solving at this point, that how do we enable our enterprise customers to be able to manage and their business and focus there, and by offering like managed EKE networking. And recently, like, we just did an alpha launch for something called NEG, Network and Endpoint Groups, and things like that. And all these offerings are going to enable our enterprises to get managed services, and they can get a seamless networking from Google. You know, being GKE, GCP, so I'm biased. I will talk about Google networking, so what we have done. So yeah, so we have we are taking GKE ingress to a very high scale using Google's load balancers and integrating them into GKE ingress. That will give you the large scale of networking and security, SSL proxies, all that you need to secure your perimeter, right? And then through the same GKE ingress, same load balancers, you can get the native load balancers for containers. You know, if you still want to continue to use NGINX, you can use. If you want to still continue to use your choice of load balancers, but if you want the scale of like the entire globe, and then being able to use the edge and the services that we have, you know, GKE ingress with our load balancers, those are the problems we solve, and we want enterprises to be free of those problems.
Right. So you've talked a lot about ingress and egress here. Can you tie this back to Istio and some of the networking challenges that you and your team are solving, and how that fits in with the Istio project?
Sure. So Istio, known as service mesh and the control plane for different kinds of proxies. Let's talk about ingress, middle, and the sidecar proxy, and sitting either with something like Envoy or, and in case of Google, integrated with Google's load balancers.
And can you tell me a little bit about what you're hearing from enterprise customers in terms of multi-cloud demands on networking?
So I'll talk about two categories of customers. So one is just the cloud-native customers. Most of our initial customers were really cloud-native customers, right? And then whereas other traditional, other cloud providers, they had initially customers onboarded, which were traditional enterprise IT customers. So I'll pick both kinds of customers. So enterprise IT customers, they are hybrid from a perspective of on-prem and some public cloud, or they may have some instances of private cloud. So they are hybrid that way. And cloud native companies, like, you know, relatively newer companies, gaming companies, Pokemon being one of them. So those companies, they were just born and brought up in cloud, right? So then those are the companies which we have most of the experiences with. So even those companies, in order to get some data locality, those kinds of rules and regulations, we see them also going to some, you know, multi-cloud kind of scenarios, just primarily for the data scenarios. But anytime you move data, you end up being in the networking space as well. So yeah, that's kind of what we are seeing. Like traditional IT companies, they are going on-prem, off-prem, and then they want a choice of another public cloud. But for cloud native companies, they started with one cloud vendor, like let's say GCP, and we also see them kind of going to other cloud providers because of some some compliance reasons or data locality reasons.
And what would you say the hardest problem is that we're working on right now from a Google perspective on networking in the cloud native space?
So hardest problem, nothing is hard for Google. We are like really smart engineers. So I say from a prioritization perspective, like, you know, what do we want to do, like, you know, in upcoming years? So we have two cloud providers, very famous ones, right? So they have a huge base of large enterprise customers. And we are really good with cloud native companies. So looking at like, you know, certain verticals and let's say retail, gaming, financials. So, and looking at those problems which we know already that we can solve, and especially like in terms of low latency, high bandwidth, anywhere, we know that we are really good at it, but how do we bundle that together and start offering them as a networking secure services, which means integrating with our IAM, you know, giving our visibility and monitoring all the way to stack drivers, and also giving like one platform APIs. So to be honest, really like networking, which crosses like the horizontal domain, how do you package that together and really kind of start bringing large enterprises together and then show them what our value add is? Because networking seems easy and that's what we want, but hard to explain. So being able to explain them so and they can visualize that, I guess that's what the problem, simple problem to solve.
Indeed. Thank you for your time, Lakshmi.